रेडियोकार्बन डेटिंग। रेडियोकार्बन डेटिंग इज अ वे ऑफ डिटरमाइनिंग द एज ऑफ सर्टेन आर्कियोलॉजिकल आर्टिफैक्ट्स ऑफ अ बायोलॉजिकल ओरिजिन अप टू अबाउट 50,000 ईयर्स ओल्ड। इट इज यूज्ड इन फाइंड द एज ऑफ थिंग्स सच एज बोन, क्लोथ, वुड एंड प्लांट फाइबर्स दैट वेर क्रिएटेड इन द रिलेटिवली रीसेंट पास्ट बाय ह्यूमन एक्टिविटीज। You probably have seen or read news about fascinating ancient artifacts. At an archaeological dig, a piece of wooden tool is unearthed and the archaeologists find it to be 5,000 years old. A child mummy is found in high in the Andes and the archaeologist says the child lived more than 2,000 years ago. How do scientists know how old an object or human remains are? What methods do they use and how do these methods work? In this chapter, we will examine the methods by which scientists use radioactivity to determine the age of objects, most notably carbon-14 dating. Cosmic rays enter the Earth's atmosphere in large numbers every day. For example, every person is hit by about 500,000 of cosmic rays every hour. It is not uncommon for a cosmic ray to collide with an atom in the atmosphere, creating a secondary cosmic ray in the form of energetic neutron, and for this energetic neutrons to collide with nitrogen atoms. When the neutrons collide, a nitrogen-14 atom turns into a carbon-14 atom and a hydrogen atom. Carbon-14 is radioactive with a half-life of about 5,730 years. Let's see about radiocarbon dating. Radiocarbon dating works by comparing the three different isotopes of carbon. Isotope of a particular element have same number of protons in the nucleus but different number of neutrons. All living organism in the world absorb CO2 from air to synthesize organic molecules. In the absorbed carbon dioxide, the major part is carbon-12 and carbon-13 and they are stable. Carbon-14 is very small in quantity and it is radioactive, whose half-life is 5,730 years. In the atmosphere, carbon-14 is continuously formed from nitrogen-14 due to the bombardment by neutrons produced from cosmic rays. Carbon-14 in the atmosphere is always decaying, but at the same time, cosmic rays from the outer space are continuously bombarding the atoms in the atmosphere, which produces carbon-14. So the continuous production and decay of carbon-14 in the atmosphere keep the ratio of carbon-14 to carbon-12 always constant. Since our human body, tree, or any living organism continuously absorbs CO2 from the atmosphere, the ratio of carbon-14 to carbon-12 in the living organism is also nearly constant. But when the organism dies, it stops absorbing CO2. Since carbon-14 starts to decay, the ratio of carbon-14 to carbon-12 in a dead organism or specimen decreases over the years. Suppose the ratio of carbon-14 to carbon-12 in the ancient object excavated is known, then the age of the ancient object can be calculated.